Great to congratulate all participants of the conference. I would like to present research on the topic application of online marketing methods and SEO technologies for web resources analysis within the region. Of the office, Volodymyr Kuchkovskiy, Vasyl Andrunyk, Maksym Krylyshyn, Lyubomyr Chyrun, Anatolii Vysotskyi, Sofia Chyrun, Nataliia Sokulska, and Ilona Brodovska. Abstract. This article presents the methods of analysis of content for information web resources within a particular region. The module describes the processes of processing information resources in content analysis systems and simplifies the technology of content management automation. The article is devoted to the development of methods and software tools for processing information resources in internet systems. A new approach to the implication and implementation of business processes is to build such systems is formulated. Methods of processing content and information resources based on SEO technology and online marketing. Software for content and information resource processing is developed. Introduction. Non-content management technology is internet marketing. With internet integration, information management, public relations, customer service, and sales in various fields. Internet marketing utilizes all aspects and essentials of traditional marketing in conjunction with new research methods and information analyzing uses modern IT. These methods of being in relatively constant contact with users are effective thanks to the automatic tracking of statistics which uses to the return on investment, e-business and visitor efficiency to analyze or conversion rate. The main purpose of internet marketing is to get the maximum effect from the potential audience of the site with the ability to instantly obtain statistics of sales, visits, demands, related works. In this picture, in this slide, you can see viral marketing and basic directions of internet marketing. And in this slide, you can see areas of internet marketing. Site conversion is the ratio of the number of visitors to the site who completed the target to the total number of visitors site. The successful conversion is interpreted differently by sellers, by advertisers, or content providers. Staying in touch with user is effective thanks to the automatic tracking of two statistics which used to return on investment and rate of return. The purpose of the application of internet marketing technologies is to get the maximum effect from the potential audience of the information resource with the ability to instantly obtain statistics of sales versus demand. And search engine marketing has the following characteristics. Work with specific queries, cold link to the search, increase of level of finding, and context analysis. In this slide, you can see technologies. The first one is a search engine marketing, and the second is a findability. Usability, it's a user, is a general convenience factor when using object. The concept of development of user interfaces of the software focused on the maximum psychological and visual convenience for the user. The result of using search engine marketing is attracting users to an information resource where the audience differs on a case-by-case and therefore attracting a broad or an interested audience and dissemination of content about information resources in search engines. The separation of search engine marketing into a separate standalone strategy is associated with continuing growth of the internet market, the growth of the contextual and search advertising market, using search engine optimization, the need for optimal navigation and surfing in content space containing text, visual, animated, and audio content, and or experience of system users. Supporting the complex content lifecycle process it goes through while managing the various stages of publishing. This slide you can see an internet marketing for e-commerce content systems. The concept of content analysis is not unequally defined, so systems built on differences approach are incompatible. Applying the content analysis to e-commerce content systems offers a number of benefits for simplifying your business and resolves a number of problems facing business process participants, namely filtering users' content on an information resource, the ability to automatically create a portrait of the regular user based on the analysis of his comments, the ability to automatically create a portrait of the target audience based on the analysis of portraits regular users, reducing the number of moderators of the information resource, and reducing the time for posting user content on an information resource due to its automatic processing but not by moderators. And the next, the second one, elimination of the language barrier due to automatic formation of dictionaries or for regular users and automatic translation. Content analysis is used in the study of sources invariant in structure, content, and existing as non-systematic, disorderly organized textual material. The method of content analysis is to form from a variety of text material, abstract model of the content of the text, and there are two methods of content analysis, quantitative and qualitative. And probabilistic modeling of text and syllables, word combination, grammar classes, and it allows to determine the amount of sample required to provide at least once the corresponding linguistic unit. Quantitative evaluation of content information in text are obtained based on the meaning of synthetic information and using the idea of contextual conditioning. And in identifying new event stream content consistently to the input ECCS by means of scanning or content route and thematically selected results. Identifying new developments in the description of the content. And content that reflects new events is the basis of interdependent content clusters. Each cluster can be the basis for the formation of a complete story chain. In this slide, you can see a mechanism, research, and content formation. Determining the content tone based on text analysis is more difficult than detecting spam. Because when detecting spam, consider two hypotheses. It's a spam or it's not a spam. And when determining the tone of the emotion and color, positive, negative, neutral, and a combination. The Bayesian method uses spam databases to determine spam to content corps, one of which is made up of spam and the other is not. And for each content, the frequency of use of each word and the weight rating are calculated. That is the conditional probability that the content with that word is spam. Weight values close to 1/2 are not taken into account, so in the integrated calculation, words with such weights are ignored and deleted. And the hypothesis space contains the negative, neutral, and positive key. And in the case of hypothesis H1, from the set with a positive tone, choose a term specific to the content. They chose terms with a probability calculated by Bayes formula and greater than 1/2. Decisions about the content tonality are made taking into account the differences between the values of the weighted estimates of the hypothesis H1 and H-1. Here you can see formulas of Paul Graham and the Bayes formula. The relation with the properties of reflexivity, summity, and transitivity is a relation of equivalence. The relation of duplication, each content according to the above algorithm of coincidence of terms in signatures is assigned a vector with elements. And in the analysis of similarity criteria, the conditions of summity and transitivity are used in this formula and changing the volume of comparison terms to find the corresponding coefficients. The cluster becomes the basis for the formulation of the story chain, and in this formula, N is the volume of content flow. C1 is the current content, Cn is latest content, and Cg is E, the content, dictionary is dictionary. If the content is a plurality of terms, then it is the union of terms from the content Cg and Ce into a vector of dimension n, which is defined as in this formula. In this slide, you can see a basic requirements for content management system for the construction of e-commerce content system, and the second is the main components of content management system for the construction of ECCS. The study also describes characteristics of measure content management systems for the development of e-commerce content system and the main components of the subsystems of processing of information, resources, and listed in the relevant tables. So, materials and methods. Content management tools in e-commerce. Several content lifecycle models is also described and listed in the relevant tables. Define the term content and content lifecycle classification, and proposed and described by several authors with the properties supported set by different technologies and processes. In some content lifecycle models, project management concept, information management, information architecture, and content strategies, a website management and semantic printing are provided. A well-known content management tool is the content management system, which is software for organizing websites or other information resources in the internet or on individual computer. So in this slide you can see requirements in the first picture, and the second is a content management system classification. Here you can see a classification of internet newspapers, and the most popular content management system is Drupal and Joomla. Content management models are designed to determine the hygienic relevance of content flow. They do not solve problems of content creation and implementation, and they not solve all content management problems. Here you can see a list of these problems. In this slide, you can see a context diagram of typical regional information resource. Forms of the information resources of some advertiser friendly are due to both, and they have the right to send their contact details and additional information about the product, services, or the advertisers. Persons who have provided information through such forms of an advertiser's information resource are potential customers, and analyzing this data and using it effectively helps build a profile for your potential audience. And to do this, you must use the following methods: optimizing your AdWords campaigns, tracking the landing page bounce rate and conversion rate, as well as comparing them to different variations for ad text that drives traffic to the page, can help you to determine how well your ad was performing. In this slide, you can see a diagram of content search ads. For example, in the table that the topic one ad group has only a high CTR compared to the similar topic 2 ad group, but also higher bounce rate. This means that more than half of the users who visited the site after clicking ads in topic group 1 did not stay there to the view and the offers to make a purchase in more detail, despite the fact that the ad group topic 2 receives fewer clicks, the return on investment in them is higher because users involved in this advertising are more likely to linger on a typical regional information resource. At this slide you can see an examples of bounce rates. So, for chosen objective, where this figure represents the percentage of visits that resulted in a conversion. Conversion occurs when a visitor reached a goal. There are three types of goal. The destination URL in the page that visitors see immediately after the action is completed, and the site time is the time limit your specify for a site moderator, and the number of pages viewed per visit allows you to determine the page view threshold. When a visitor views more or fewer pages, then the limit conversion is complete. Also, there are four types of targets for choose him. When a visitor completes a selected action, a conversion is triggered and recorded in goal reports. You can select the type of tracking goal you want to do. There are four types of targets to choose from. When a visitor completes a selected action, a conversion is triggered and recorded in goal reports. You can select the type of tracking goal you want from the list when setting up a goal in your account. Compared to homepage metrics, this metric compares the conversion rate of the experiment page and the original page, and the comparison is made by the following formula. Attribution modeling lets you compare the impact of different attribution model on evaluating marketing channels. In the tool, select an attribution model, and then the table will show the number of conversations for each channel calculated by the model you selected. So here you can see a picture paid ads example. In this slide, you can see a contextual DFT is a typical regional information resource. And this slide shows a detailed DFD of a typical regional information resource and an ERD of a typical regional information resource. Mathematical relation for a deterministic system in the general case. For the site of the city of Lviv, consider the model administrative visitor described in more detail the study and discrete deterministic model information system. And here you can see a discrete stochastic model of information system example. This slide shows us a mealy machine example where it is requested to the server. Is the processing of the request, is running to the script, is connection to the database, and generation on delivery to the page of the visitor. Here you can see a network model example. And at this slide, an aggregation system example. Conclusion. The analysis of ways of formulation of commercial content is carried out, and the known models of a life cycle of content and the standardized services of management of content that gives the chance to define requirements for creation of an optimum life cycle of commercial content and investigated. Internet technologies for the construction of service-oriented e-commerce system are studied, which made it possible to classify e-commerce systems and e-content commerce systems. Information resources and production processes of e-commerce systems are considered in detail, which makes it possible to develop an optimal content life cycle and a typical architecture of e-commerce systems. The technology of content management in e-commerce is analyzed, which allows developing formal models, unfilled methods, and software tools for processing information resources in e-content commerce system. From the standpoint of a systematic approach of analysis, is modern methods and tools for designing, modeling, and implementation of electronic content commerce system as well. The technology of content management in e-commerce is analyzed, which allows developing formal models, unified methods and software tools for processing information resource in e-content commerce system. From the standpoint of a systematic approach of an analysis of modern methods and tools for designing, modeling and implementation of electronic content commerce systems, as well as substantiated the need and feasibility of creating an unified methods and software for processing information resource. Thank you very much.